character was funny, feisty. She had attitude and just all around, she was beautiful.
On Monday, May 28, 2018, around 11 a.m., Austin alumni Amanda Akaji was 3 miles away from Balmoria, Texas, when a sudden event occurred and unfortunately took the life of 4 people, including the soon-to-be mother of 4, Amanda Grado Akaji.
Her and her husband went to San Antonio to, he was in a basketball team. And on their way back to El Paso, they had a blow-up, a flat, and the van rolled over. And they were ejected, and they passed instant. Amanda loved basketball. I mean, that was her thing.
She was like the enforcer. You know, she was a good sized girl, and she could use her body, and she knew how to put people in a position, you know, to get people out of position with her physical ability. And so she used it to her advantage, sometimes too hard, sometimes it was a little too rough, but she knew what she could do for the team to help us, and she always did that.
She was aggressive. She had a lot of fouls. So every time I would do the book, I'd be, Amanda, calm down, you already have 3 fouls. And she would just tell me to be quiet. But I knew she was in the zone, so I was like, I never took offense to it. And as soon as she fouled out, I was like, I told you so. And then she would just laugh, and she was like, well, you should have been more stubborn.
You mean she just wanted everybody to get along, and, you know, and that's basically what kind of sisterhood comes through when you play basketball. You know, you love each other with all your wrongs, and trust me, we all have wrongs. And so she was that type of person that loved everybody and took everybody in. It didn't matter who they were or where they came from.
She was the life of the team. Big personality, always fun, always joking, always playful. Loved basketball. And so it always made the practices and the games and just, you know, the camaraderie of the team better because she just had this bigger-than-life personality.
The Austin High School girls basketball team decided to commemorate the 2010 Austin graduate and 7-month pregnant Amanda Akaji by dedicating 2018 and 19 basketball season to her.
Several of her teammates had reached out to us, and we thought it'd be a special connection for us. When you do things like this, it usually spiritually pushes you a little bit more to give more effort or to just fight a little bit more, because you're representing something more than yourself or representing more than the school. You're representing a memory of somebody.
For support, definitely, but also because it's important to us. It's just kind of, I think it's a way to show respect and just give our condolences to her passing.
I think it's a big honor because, you know, she put her sweat and tears on that court, and it's very, like, admirable to know that the girls are dedicating the season to somebody they didn't even know, but they have this sisterhood through them, through the fact that we all played basketball in the school.
It's a great thing to see, you know, in our generation growing up, not a lot of people know the importance of friendship or family and likewise, but the fact that Austin and the coach that's taking care of the women's basketball team allowed us to bring this memorial or this memory to the school and allow her to be recognized, not just as a basketball player, but for us to know the person she was growing up.
You value, you know, that the girls loved her very much.
No matter where they are, no matter how many years have passed, we're always going to be a family.
Not only is it a message for today's girls that are currently playing, but it sends a really strong message to the girls of the past, like, you matter. And you built a legacy, and we're going to continue that, whether you're here or not.